made you come here?
This week, madam, we offer one red rose with each year's subscription to the medical journal.
Oh, no, please, you've got to go.
Well, my dear, I see you have company. Come in, sir. Come in. Any friend of Margot's is welcome.
Thank you. I must apologize
for... Please leave.
I'm afraid we haven't a servant in the house. I let them all go for the weekend. Did Margot tell you that we're flying east tonight?
That's why I'm here.
Indeed. May I have the pleasure of your company?
No. I don't know how to say this, and I hope you understand, but you're not going to have the pleasure of your daughter's company either.
And we'll explore that remark over a drink. Come along. Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
Highball? I want that mix with what you've had.
That'll be fine, thanks.
Jeff, please leave.
Don't be so inhospitable, my dear. And where did you two meet? At the drugstore tonight?
Oh, no. No, we've been seeing each other every night.
Seeing each other every night? Lovely. So you must be the young man.
Mr. Lannington, there's no sense beating around the bush. I'm in love with your daughter.
That's quite apparent.
Can't you see he's had too much to drink?
Yes, I can see it. And is Margot in love with you?
Well, hasn't she told you?
As a matter of fact, she has, yes. Well, that's quite romantic, Mr...
Doctor. Dr. Cameron.
Not a psychiatrist. Hmm. No. And not a very substantial practice, as yet.
Well, I think we can manage to get along without any help from you, if that's what you mean.
It is what I mean.
Jeff, I...
Be quiet, Margot. You mind being not quite so demonstrative in my presence? So you're quite sure of your feelings. I mean, you know, people sometimes get carried away, come to their senses again with a jolt.
Mr. Lannington, I want to marry your daughter.
I wish you'd stop calling her my daughter. She happens to be my wife.
I was afraid to tell you. Afraid I'd lose you. I'd always hoped he'd give me a divorce. If I lost you, I'd have nothing. I'd have nothing.
It's your wife.
Yes. Doctor? Well, I concede the conspicuous difference in our ages. Margot married me for my money. I married her for her youth. We both got what we wanted. After a fashion.
Where are you going?
I think I'll go out and get some fresh air.
Not without me.
You lied to me. My father's old. On borrowed time.
I lied because I love you. I knew you wouldn't understand.
I don't understand.
I never loved him. I tell you, I never loved him.
Of that, there was never any question. My dear. But I can assure you she's had many very good reasons for being grateful. So, you're bowing out. Well, I think that's wise. Scandal can be quite damaging to a career.
You don't think that's why I'm going?
The point's irrelevant. Good night, Dr. Cameron.
Jeff, tonight, when I came back, he told me I could go away with you. He told me tonight.
That's true. Up to a point. Well, the bags are packed. If you want her, you can have her. Only first, I think you should know what you're getting. Tomorrow is too late to repent.
Jeff, don't listen to him. He'll say anything, do anything. Jeff, don't go!